Hello all, myself Soumya KS, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Commerce, GFTC Baramsagara. In this video, we shall see how to compute the taxable capital gain of the house property. Here is a problem. Mr. X acquired a house property in the year 2005-6 for rupees 5 lakh. The actual cost of acquisition was 5 lakh and paid rupees 85,000 as registration fee. That is the transfer expenses 85,000. Mr. X died on 15-9-2010 and the property was transferred to his son Mr. Y by inheritance. On the death of Mr. X, the property, house property, was transferred by inheritance to Mr. Y, who is X's son. The market value of the property as on 15-9-2010, that is when it is transferred to his son, was rupees 12 lakh. Fair market value was 12 lakh. Mr. Y sold the property on 31st May 2019 for rupees 25,50,000. Compute the capital gain for the assessment year 2020-21. CII for the financial year 5-6, 2010-11 and 19-20 are 107, 167 and 289 respectively. Let's see how to compute the taxable capital gain of Mr. Y as Mr. X was died. Now we are calculating this capital gain for the Mr. Y. Here the first thing, it is a long term capital gain because it was purchased in 2005-6 and now it is sold on 2019. So it's a long term capital gain. The sale proceeds of the house is 210 now note. That is 25,50,000. 25,50,000 is the sale proceed of the house. Less indexed cost of acquisition. Indexed cost of acquisition. Yeah, first cost of acquisition is today. I'm not big. Cost of acquisition was 5 lakh plus 85,000 transfer expenditure madidare. So that both together 5 lakh plus 85,000. 5 lakh 85,000 we have to consider as actual cost of acquisition. 5 lakh 85,000 into 289, that is CII for the year 2019-20. Yav year alle or sale maadta idare aa year alli irthakkanta CII divided by CII for 2005-6. 2005-6 ge irthakkanta CII, that is 117. Now we get 14 lakh rupees. So sale proceeds 25,50,000 minus 14 lakh is cost of indexed cost of acquisition. Then the long term capital gain which is taxable is 11,50,000. Here question comes. Then what about this fair market value? Why it is not considered? It is the fair market value is 12 lakh. During it is transferred by inheritance, it should not be considered because here it is not sold. Instead, it is transferred by inheritance. And now one more thing, cost of acquisition of the house, that is 2005. As I already told, it is 5 lakh plus 85,000. 5 lakh is the cost of purchase, 85,000 is registration fees. Total of this is 5 lakh 85,000 that we have taken here as to calculate the indexed cost of acquisition. For further reference, you can refer these textbooks and study material. Thank you.